Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This set of videos focus on tracking. Previously, you saw how to perform a single point position track using layers in the sequence. Now let's repeat the first example, only this time we will use ConnectFX, the Action 3D compositor, and the axis nodes to do the track. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Here is the same shot from the previous video without the arrow media on the second layer. Select the segment in the sequence, click the effects button, and choose Create Connect Effects. In the ConnectFX node bin, drag out an action and drop it into the connection. At this point, it is important to reiterate that if you want to do any tracking, you need to track a background input. With that said, you can see that the car source node is going into the action background input. Without this, you would just get a black background when entering into the stabilizer. Double-click on the action node to enter into the node controls. Hover over the ConnectFX schematic and press Escape to see the action schematic. Now we could import the arrow source clip and track that. In fact, you can track any image you want. However, just to keep things interesting, you can track anything you want, including 3D models. Ensure you are in the Action Bin menu. In the Node bin, double-click on the Import node to enter into the file browser. Change the file type to FBX. Navigate to the folder containing the downloaded media. Here, you should find an FBX 3D model. Just select it and import it into the Action Composite. You should now see the arrow and a bunch of nodes in the Action Schematic. Double-click on the Light node and enable shading in its menus. Coming back to the 3D model, the components consist of an Axis node, a Geom node, and a Material node. The Geom and Material nodes offer 3D geometry. However, the Axis node is universal for 3D models, surfaces, objects, and layers. Object tracking is always performed using axis nodes in action. So here would be a typical tracking workflow. Switch to the action bin. Drag out a new axis and connect it to the top of the existing branch. Rename the axis object to track. So similar to the axis timeline effects, all tracking is performed at the top axis. Double-click on the axis to bring up its menus. Here is the stabilizer button as before, and it is configured to only track position by default. Click the stabilizer button, and we're back in the same menu. As before, pick up the tracker boxes and position them at the front of the car. Now let's analyze the result again. Incidentally, if you have done the track and you want to save it, just click the Save and Load buttons next to the Return button of the stabilizer. So returning back to the Action 3D compositor, you can see we have duplicated the track we did earlier, but with this workflow. To offset the arrow like the previous video, we would use the axis node beneath the axis used for the track. Select the original axis node for the 3D arrow and reposition it onto the roof of the car. Obviously, with a 3D model, you can do a lot more rotation and orientation to make it look better than just a flat image. But at the end of the day, I'll leave that to you to decide. If your model looks a bit jaggy, just switch to the CFX preferences and enable hardware anti-aliasing. Now exit ConnectFX and render the final result. So that concludes the two basic workflows for doing a simple one-point position track. Let's move on to the next example, showing two-point tracking for position, rotation, and scale. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.